So we have reached up to this point where suggested a reflection spot, and now we will just go ahead because we need to go to the second session. Okay, so this is how we did, and average learner will do it in a similar or some such fashion. The question here is that, and now we are coming to towards, when we are coming towards closure, and you had heard and seen various principles what we discussed yesterday. There is a element of LCM, what we call this as, so creating a LED or LBD are all elements of MOOC, and we are now trying to see how different principles are required or can be used in order to create a create these elements. So question for all of you, we give a right and a wrong answer at times, and then this is what the feedback will tell us, that this is the wrong answer and this is the right answer. Now based on the discussion what you had yesterday, can you tell us which are the principles which are getting violated here? You may not know the exact name of the principle, that's okay, you can just narrate this feedback. Okay, what's wrong with feedback? It's giving me feedback that it green and red and all that. Why it is wrong? Okay, so why it is wrong is an informative feedback that this is not wrong, and on top of that, so I will come to know that I was wrong because of this, then what? Have I actually learnt? No. So what else I should? Yeah, for every possible wrong answer, there should be reason why it is wrong. That I got it, but just giving it, telling me that it is wrong, is it? There should be some corrective measure, right? I should be able to correct myself, and then so my knowledge should go beyond that point. So therefore, there should be what you saw in the, which example did we see that? In the Khan Academy, it told us that okay, if you want to learn again, you have a link, another link which will take you to the perfect topic which corresponds to this misconception, because the system or the instructors have identified a misconception here in the mind of the learner, and they are clear that this is not going right. Therefore, they will give you pointers so that you can correct yourself by visiting that and then come back. So just by telling this is wrong, then I am not getting anywhere. So this is a violation of a feedback principle as well as the response principle. So feedback is just telling you right or wrong, but response goes beyond that in terms of correctivity. Now the small activity for all of you is that you have put up a reflection spot. Now try and see how you can apply these things in that reflection spot. And first of all, I check whether you have already applied it, and if you have not, then let us do that. And I would like to actually pass on the microphone where you can actually narrate what was that and how it had changed. Clarification, all of you have a script for LED right now, okay, and you don't have a script for LBD. So whatever questions you have asked as a reflection spot, will not have that luxury of hyperlink and all that, which is not expected also. But what is expected, and that brings to a closure part of LED, is that after you add a reflection spot, you should have a clarification followed by it, which will cover all the possible options and a description about that in the later part of that video. So your video which tells you now it has actually only one, and then you can show that now it has only one edge and one surface, is what they will get as an answer. Although if they have expected the right answer or they have missed out on that, whatever way, they will get the clarification. So the structure of a LED typically looks like you have a explanatory video or text, whatever, and then you have the reflection spot, and then there is a clarification part also. Now this order can change. You can start with a reflection spot also. It doesn't mean that every time you have to start always with a video to save it. So there are, we saw on Khan Academy also, take a quiz was the first screen, right? And then explanation will come following that, because they wanted to first look out what are the misconceptions, and then they'll address them. So that is fine. Now coming to the point which we were discussing, if you have that as a reflection spot and you are building a LBD along with it, now you ask a question, are you able to visualize that what should be re-looked at by the learners in order to answer them correctly? So giving four answers in a reflection spot is correct. However, remember to clarify or touch base all of them when you do a explanation video post the reflection spot. Is it clear? So let's just try for that. We're giving one small LBD thing, right? Yeah. So that they will have a sample of how a LBD looks like. So all of you can just have a LBD followed by this LED what you have written. You can just put some enter and say now this is LBD for that.
So all of you would have been doing the worksheet now, LED creation. So after LED creation, you have the LBD creation. Once you have done the LED, I'll just put down the instructions for LBD creation. So in this session, you can just focus on creating a learning by doing activity, which is a multiple choice question. Okay. Yeah, true or false. So there are two choices, right? It's a multiple choice. Multiple choice, single answer, multiple answer, all are valid. Yeah, it is. It has to be posted in the draft folder. Okay, the same LED creation document. Just create an LBD also. Okay, so while you are giving feedback, please note that you have to follow the feedback principle. Do not just give right or wrong. You should make the feedback in such a way that the person is able to move from wrong to right. So this is known as a constructive feedback. Okay, this is what we call constructive feedback. So all of you have now written a script. For your script, now write an LBD, which is a multiple choice question. Ensure that you are providing feedback for all the options.
Okay. So I had a chance to talk to a couple of you, and I saw that what I can summarize is that people are getting towards detailed clarification to be provided, and that's okay, because we are all trying to say that the learner should know everything in detail. Okay, going ahead. So here is the activity. All of you back from your LBDs, enough of doing, let us go further. So while designing a learning extension for a topic of ICT for teachers, and all of you have taken this course already. Now, the instructor should point to a source about which of the following: examples of use of ICT, technologies which are useful for teachers, career opportunities, or public speaking skills. So, A, B, C, D. How many? Multiple correct answers are possible. Okay, let us see which is not possible, which is not required. D, I can hear louder, but which is the other alphabet? C, okay. Career opportunities? Okay. Public speaking skills? Why? Why they don't fall under this category? Because the topic is of ICT for teachers, right? So it is about information and communication technology, although public speaking is communication, but we are not talking about that communication. What we are talking about are the technologies. Therefore, it is good to have knowledge about it, but not maybe part of this topic. So therefore, it is.
Suppose we change career opportunities to career opportunities for ICT teachers.
Ah, okay. Or public speaking skills using technology. So the moment we, what we are doing here is that this connected to the topic is a very diverse thing. The moment we have some element of what the topic is, then we suddenly find it connected. So for example, using a microphone is a technology for public speaking. It's a technology tool which I should know where to wear the mic and all sorts of things. So then that suddenly becomes a connected point. But if I just say public speaking and what should be your body language and all that, it is nothing to do with ICT for teachers in that topic. So this is very important to know, because while doing the learning extensions, there is a great possibility of just derailing from this objective and going and converting this activity to merely a list of references, which is what we don't want to have, because nobody will look at it. More you are connected to the topic, more they are pointed and directing towards things, then there is a advantage of people using it effectively and utilizing it there. So one such example, and all of you have seen this, in the FDP 101X, the topic was about foundation program on ICT for education, and one of the theme was about creating your web presence. Now there are multiple technologies available for that, and they are evolving. So there is no point pinpointing that, okay, only do this. So therefore, we created a learning extension which will talk specifically about using Drupal as one of the technologies. Now people who want to spend time in some other technology and they know about it or they want to learn, fair enough. However, we just pointed you to set of some videos. There were 63 actually, and you can see the caution written here that though you may not need to watch all the 63 videos, we give you a recommendation of something. What it shows is that the instructor has defined that connected part very well. That this much is connected to you, so only watch this much, don't go for the entire thing. That is where it has to be. Now if that is done and not supported by assimilation quiz, then there is also a chance of people not doing it. Therefore, an assimilation quiz was followed by this activity, and if you look at it, the questions are at what level here? Drupal is an example of a CMS. What does CMS stand for? So what is this question type? blooms, huh? It would be a very lower order question. So people who have just browsed through these YouTube videos also will be able to answer it, and they have learned something that Drupal is one type of CMS. That much information if you have as an instructor and who knows ICT tools, we thought it was enough. Therefore, it was only at that level. People who have gone ahead and made their own Drupal sites will obviously gain, and people who have not done a Drupal site also will gain that now I know one CMS. That was the kind of situation here. Therefore, what it comes to is I have shown you the example, and because this team had done it, I don't want to show you that. I want you guys to imagine what was the things what the instructors had done in getting this example here. So what could be their activities? Yeah, so you saw that Drupal links posted and assimilation quiz created. Now, yeah, these are broad level activities, but what all, what could be list of things what online instructor had done? Identified
out of those 63,
okay, identified the connected chunks out of the huge list, right? So maybe identified the pertinent. Is this fine? Identified the pertinent content out of the pool of content. Anything else? Develop quiz questions, okay. Okay. Any sub bullet for this created quiz questions?
Explanation for the wrong or right
answer. Okay. Was there any wrong or right? Okay. Maybe. Okay. Anything? So that is what identifying out of the 63 which are the ones which are connected, that was already done. Okay, so the level of questions was set at that point. Okay, so created quiz questions at star level, let us just say this much. Okay, some level. Anything? So let us see. And what did the students do? Watch videos. Read the. Okay, answer the. Okay, solve. Follow the video. Okay. So it is before this, right? Okay, something like that. Let us see. Right. So what instructor did was provided instructions. So not just posting YouTube video links, that is not enough. Then you have to actually give the link, which is desirable. Create the quiz. Design the recall level questions, yes, all of us said that, but the last point is important. Assign a weightage. Now, not assigning a weightage has a problem because people may not take it seriously, and assigning a huge weightage to it will be like you are asking out of syllabus things to us. So, assigning minimum weightage solves the problem in the most nicer way. So, I think you had 10% weightage for all assimilation quizzes, right, in the FDP. Yes. So that 10% was good enough for people to attempt it, at the same time not so much that people can just leave it. And so on the other side, students read the instructions, watch the videos and solve the quizzes, and in the whole thing actually may have learnt new things. I am going to actually show one more example here, which is slightly away from this. Okay. So, in my course on animation, we had a peculiar situation. So a learner, we had an assignment of creating this chess piece. I mentioned another problem yesterday. This is one more issue. So learner A has posted a problem on the forum saying that I am not able to do this. On the other hand, learner B has already created a chess piece and posted. And then everybody is asking learner B, how did you create it? When the learner B said that I did something, it was very vague, because on discussion forum she could not write a long list of activities. So what I suggested to her was that here is a link for the spoken tutorial project of IIT Bombay, where it talks about how to create screencast videos along with your audio. I told her that go to this link and see if you can create a video of explaining people how to make a chess piece and post it back on the forum. I was absolutely not sure whether she will do this. To my surprise, she did and posted that video, and subsequent submissions were all like that, because people started following that video and did their own assignments and started posting it there. Now this is that YouTube link actually, and maybe we are anyway going to share this. You can have a look at this, because it's a very nicely done video. The person is a teacher in a college at Rajkot, and what she did was followed all the standard processes, announcing which version I am working on, what is my configuration of the system, and all that is explained in the beginning, and followed by that steps wise video of how I am doing this particular thing, and people started following it. So what has happened here is a learning extension was created on the fly. The learning extension was not created. So I wanted them to apply their knowledge, what they have learnt, when I am telling them about how to create a extruded surface. So this is what I am teaching them in my video, which is the LED, and I am trying to tell them that now that I have shown you extruded surface of a bottle, apply this knowledge to create a chess piece. I am not giving another video of telling them how to make a chess piece and asking them to submit the same thing. So that is what now I am not doing, because I want them to apply. Some students have a problem in application where a support material is required, and it is created by another peer, which is the most interesting part here, and they found it very interesting, and later on I found out that the person is continuing with creating such more videos and distributing in their own groups, which is a good sign. But it also brings us to another point which we had discussed as an element of LCM, which is LXI. So what was that? It was about learner interactions. This is one example of how discussion forum was useful in getting such an interaction, because it was a it has to be triggered by a certain action, in which case I just worked upon this point of a learner saying that I am not able to do it. I made it a point that it becomes an interaction, rather than giving a straightforward answer that here is a video to do it, and it could have just stopped there. So I said that can anyone help her, and then people came up and then they started interacting, and it just continued, because till the end. So what you can see on the screenshot, so people are praising this person, saying that this is very nice, I am not able to get this scratchy surface on this, how did you get it, I got the clean surface. Then that person will make another video of how to get that scratchiness. So all this is what is the experience part, and this is critical, especially in MOOC setting, because you are not in a classroom with the same people at the same time. But discussion forum or any other channel for that matter will provide you such opportunities where you can actually have interactions and get the experience out of it. So experience part is the most critical here, through the interactions which are happening, rather than just watching the videos and learning things. This gives you a facility to interact with each other. So that was that is why I wanted to show you this. So maybe if you can read it here. Actually, I am not, please explain me how you did it and all that. So see, this kind of questions were what triggered entire discussion. Okay. So what are the elements which you should, what are the important things you should remember for getting that into LXI mode? Focus question and instructions, very, very clear instructions, and instructions for posting as well as for discussion. So somebody wants to start something new, how should they do that is very critical. So writing this focus question and instructions for posting will keep it very clean. So we had a reflection quiz based on this, which enabled people to go through all the discussions on that thread so that they can answer that reflection. So that is one concluding way of how you can start this interaction and then conclude it by asking a reflection quiz on that. So this is what we wanted to share with you as the LXI part of it. Types of questions used for reflection quiz. Now it's having a clear instruction, browse the discussion forum and try to find these things. Now trying to find a trend means that you have to go through all the discussions, because you cannot spot one particular thing. That is the whole purpose of such an quiz. So that, so which of the following is a common challenge posted by your peer? So out of multiple challenges, you have to pick one, but certainly you have to go through those multiple first in order to. So that is where we have come to this point of in one, acknowledge the specific user, right? So this is the second one, that which was the challenge mentioned, and they are verbatim text, so you can just select one of them. I think for each of us teachers can collaborate. So who has provided this comment? So such pointed questions make the learners go through the entire discussion. Also they learn a lot because they are able to read various angles of expression, what people have said on that. That is okay. So you have done the LBD part. Now this is the LXT. Identify one LXT for the topic that you have selected. It could be either of the web link, a video or a document.
So all of you, it could be either or, a video or a document, that is, but it has to be connected to the topic. Just remember, it has to be connected to the topic and it has to be an LXT. We'll worry about the assimilation quiz later, but for the time being, you try to find out resources. And while you are finding resources, one important thing I do not have to remind you is about the licenses, okay? If you have identified resources for your LXTs, the next following step is assimilation quiz. So write one assimilation quiz question. Do not write too many questions. Just one assimilation quiz question. And rules for assimilation quiz question, it should not be too complex. Just have to ensure that they have gone through the resource. That is good enough for an assimilation quiz. And the weightage would be, the grading weightage would be less for an assimilation quiz. So even a recall activity, who spoke in the video, is good enough for a assimilation quiz in some cases. Have you not done yet in all our elements? No, so we have done LED, we have done LED script, we have done LBD question with feedback, we have done LXT and assimilation quiz. What we have not done is what? Okay, so one big element in our MOOC, so connected to learning, is a learning experience interaction, okay, the LXI, or the discussion forum, as many of you would be familiar with. Now, the next activity is for you to write a discussion forum, learning experience interaction for your own topic. All you have to do is write the stem for learning experience interaction, because learning experience interaction is actually the discussion forum plus reflection quiz. Reflection quiz will actually depend on what all discussions are happening. So you can, for the time being, we are not looking at that, but it will be good to think about it at the time of planning itself. For this particular activity, we'll just write the stem for learning experience interaction. That is, you'll have to write one focus question. There should be instructions for posting, and there should be instructions for discussion. Okay, for your own topic. Let's hear from one of the side. Give me a topic that you are doing. Weathering and erosion in geographic process. Okay. What will be a focus question? So what is the focus question for? What do you want your students to discuss in weathering and erosion? Okay, the process and types. So what will be a focus question that you will give for the students to discuss? Why do you want the students to discuss erosion or the types of erosion? Why do you want them to discuss it? Let's come from there.
So, for this kind of a question, what we can do is, see, you can connect it to students' local context. For example, one focus question that you can give is that what is the type of weathering you see around your, in your geographical area? Okay, so different students are in different areas, they will give different comments, and then there can be something like that. So the purpose of this focus question is to get diverse answers from different students, which will benefit all the students from knowing. So somebody from Rajasthan will give one set of answers, somebody else who is in Kerala will give a different set of answers for the same question. And so the person who is in Rajasthan will get to see, okay, what is the type of weathering that's happening in Kerala, the, and vice versa. So that is the purpose of this learner experience interaction. So let's do an example for one more topic. Let's take one topic from this side. What are you working on? You're working on data structures. Okay. So if you want to give a learner experience interactions for data structures, you can talk to them, you can give a focus question. Yeah. Do you have a focus question already?
We have some stack, topic of stack, where we can tell them the, about the application of stack and how it is going to be work in reversing a particular string.
Okay.
this is an application of stack that if you want to reverse a particular string.
But what are the students going to do? So this, because you said tell, we can tell. See, those verbs that we use ourselves, we have to be very alert to. So your focus is saying that what you are going to tell them. But this is, you want to ask them a question. You want to ask students a question so that they can tell something. Right? So in the topic of data structures, for example, you can ask a question like, in the discussion forum, you can ask a question like, where all do you see applications of data structures in real life? Okay. So, for example, then you will say, okay, somebody may say, when I go to the railway station, I'm standing in a queue, then I see an application of a queue. When I go to a, you know, let's say a government office, when I see the files, I see the application of a stack. So different people can give different replies, and by looking at the different replies, everybody can learn more. So that is one purpose for the learner experience interaction. Is that making sense? How to write these focus questions? Okay.
Yeah, so now that you have an idea of how to write a focus question, spend 5 minutes in writing a focus question and also instructions for discussion. So this is one point that, so just continuing on what the two examples that we have given already, what will they discuss on? So for in the case of erosion example, one instruction for discussion could be that go to another person's post and comment on how different that erosion pattern is with the erosion pattern that you see in your area. So this will make them go there, post what is the difference. So reply to three of your peers on how different or similar are the erosion patterns. For the case of stacks, the real life application, you can say you find one similar data structure that you have found out and two different data structures that you have found out in the applications. So this will make them go and look at what all are the similar kind of, so how many of them have given an example for queues, how many of them have given examples for stacks, and there they will start commenting. So this instructions for discussion is also very important. So it's not just sufficient that you ask your students to post, you should also force them to reply to the others with a pointed question. So this is essentially like your think, pair, share. You build on the first think, then there is a pairing happening. So you can, and it is already shared since it is a discussion forum. And this is one way of doing think, pair, share in an online setting. Adapted.
What have you done already today morning? From today morning is
first you have created a LED script with a reflection spot in it. Then you have done an LBD activity. I mean, you have created an LBD activity for the same topic. Then you have done both, you have found out an LXI, wrote one assimilation quiz, and also you have put up the stem for learner experience interactions. So what you have essentially done is, now we have gone into details of individual elements. If you actually think of the IIT Bombay X, yesterday we did the left hand side where the modules were there. Today we have gone in deep into individual blocks within a particular module. So essentially you have one module with you. You know how to work on it. Now a take home activity would be try to do this for the four modules or three, four modules that you have thought of in your own course. But before moving on, so you had spent around 15 to 20 minutes today for preparing a script today. So let's try to figure out how much time are we spending for each of these elements. Okay, so This is a think pair share activity. You have to, so the scenario is that you have to create a 8 to 10 minute telling video to explain a certain concept, and you are going to do a learning dialogue. So from now onwards, whatever is the telling, it's all in learning dialogue. Okay. How much time will be required to produce this video after your script is finalized? Okay, so you have done this, so you have, all of you are now in that phase. All of you have scripts and you want to create a video after the script is finalized. Think individually. I'll give you around 30 seconds to think about this. So think about the current topic. So 8 to 10 minutes, the same topic, you have another one, 10 minutes. Okay, I think people are started. So all of you have a figure in mind, just share it with your neighbor and come to a common time frame. Okay, let's share. I wanted to know what was the least duration somebody thought of.
So it's a 10 minute video.
Like any.
How many of you?
How much?
I have an answer, say 10 minutes.
12 minutes. For to capture a 10 minute video, the estimation is 12 minutes minimum. No, let us say one number, minimum and maximum is like a variable. Minimum 10, 12 minutes, okay. Anybody had a upper side for 10 minute video, what was the, it's like a 20 minutes, okay. More? Half an hour or 1 hour? 1 hour. Anybody more than 1 hour? Okay, so we have from 15 minutes to 1 hour. There are few people in the audience who have actually done it. Let us ask them what was their experience. 1 hour. Okay, we have one person who has done many videos already. But what? How much time did it take for you for the first video? Just tell us.
First video.
After the script was ready.
On an average, a teacher took around 1 hour to record 20 minutes video. If a script is ready, slides are ready, and all the materials are ready. And it also depends on the type of video he is recording.
Correct.
If it's animation video, 2 or 3 minutes video took 1 or 2 days.
Right.
So this is the thing.
Yeah, so we are talking about we as characters.
In that case, one hour for 20 minute video will work.
Yes. So the reason for asking him is, for most of you who don't know, Dr. Yogendra Pal, alumnus of Education Technology Department, and he has, I don't know how many videos to his credit?
At present, I have 3200
videos. Okay. So, one of the best person who can talk about how much time does it require. Anybody else has a experience of creating, shooting their own videos, or they have attended a video recording session where they have seen the estimation?
Actually, I have done the work, but for 45 minutes I will take for complete and upload.
Okay, after the script was ready and the slides ready, 45 minutes.
Yes, 45 minutes.
So, yeah, there is fair amount of diversity even in this because we are calculating various variables in that. Are we amount of retakes we have to do and slide progression is not happening accordingly. and certain things. One more.
I have a question for him.
Yeah, please.
Generally for repo.
Yes. What technology are we using? Hi.
I have one question for him, for the sir. That for recording any video, how many time you can retake or?
So it depends on the experience our teacher.
For the first 5 videos, you have to record multiple times, 5 to 10 times also. But for others video, you will record at most at once. Yes, you will record most of the video.
One take.
On one take.
One take, okay. In film language, as they call it, one take, okay. Yeah.
If one is going to edit the video after recording,
yes,
then it will take less time.
Yes. So this is important point. Please don't forget that there is something called editing also available. So no need to redo the whole thing from the first word onwards again if you miss out on a sentence which is toward the end of your script. So don't worry, you can do a edit, and yeah, there will be occasional jerk. In fact, if you have such a question, there is a video done by Dr. Pal on how to avoid such things also. So you can refer to that video as a LX3.
So before moving on to the break, what you have done is now an estimate runtime of an LED. Now think of how much time will a learner take to consume your video.
I mean, you will have to think of learners, what will be the percentage of engagement. So you have created a 4 minutes. Out of those 4 minutes, how much will a learner watch? Okay. So, yeah, how much they will watch. So some people may watch just half, some people may watch twice, thrice. So put up an average time that your video is going to be watched. So that is the learner consumption time. And now after you have done this, you also have to think for your own course, what is the total number of LEDs that you are going to create? Yeah, so estimate that number. So you have a 4 weeks. So in our workshop, we had looked at a 4 week course. So estimate the total number of LEDs that you will shoot for your course. Now, once you have done this, we just talked of shooting time now. Okay, shooting time was 10 minute video, 1 hour to 2 hour based on experience and other things. Now, just think of the time that you would require to plan. Planning means script writing, right from script writing. Plan, shoot, if there is editing, editing time, and finally publishing time. Publishing is publishing in some source. So combine all these, estimate it for all the LEDs that you are planning, and think of the time that you need just for LEDs. If you are going to create a course, just estimate the time that you would require just to create LEDs. Okay. We'll come up with a new principle in the next session. So we'll reassemble at 1:40.